Welcome to World Class Championship Wrestling, the Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars from the famed Cotton Bowl here on the internationally famous grounds of the State Fair of Texas. It is a beautiful afternoon for Wrestling Star Wars. I'm Bill Mercer. Great to have you with us. And we have a fantastic main event. It's Kevin, Kerry, and Mike Von Erich against Gino Hernandez, Jake the Snake Roberts, and gentleman Chris Adams, the six-man World Tag Championship. That's our main event. A lot more great bouts. Right now, though, let's go to the ring and singing of God Bless America by Ralph Pulley.
Far across the sea, let us pledge allegiance to a land that's free. Let us all be grateful for a land so fair as we raise our voices in a solemn America, land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above, from the mountains and to the prairies, to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the first annual Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars, presented by the State Fair of Texas, the largest state fair in the world. All matches are sanctioned by the National Wrestling Alliance.
Ah, it's great to be an American here in Texas, here at the Cotton Bowl of the State Fair of Texas, for this Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars. And we'll be back with our first match of the exciting World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment. Iceman King Parsons coming into the ring here at the Cotton Bowl, the State Fair of Texas, for his bout with Hacksaw Butch Reed. And the Legion of Fans welcoming in a man from St. Louis, Iceman King Parsons. And he's got a tough match with a tough man, the Hacksaw Man, Butch Reed. But King Parsons generally gives up a little height, a little weight, a little size. It doesn't seem to bother him too much. Here's the Hacksaw Man. A huge crowd at the Cotton Bowl for this Cotton Bowl Star Wars Wrestling festivities.
This event won fall 10-minute time limit. First of all, behind me, from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing 260 pounds, Hacksaw Butch Reed. And his challenger from St. Louis, weighing 235 pounds, Iceman King Parsons. Your referee is Rocco Lubitsch.
Come on, ice cream boy. Come on, ice cream boy. I'm gonna whoop some ice cream out your drawers, boy. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna whoop all the ice cream out your drawers. You understand me?
Well, there's the threat laid out there by Hacksaw Butch Reed. And we'll see how well he pulls this off as he meets the tough young man from St. Louis, Iceman King Parsons. Away they go. Hacksaw just about works as his name implies. He'll hack and bash and try a little bit of everything and miss a few times. He's got an adversary and a flying drop kick by Iceman King Parsons. Moves right it on and Hacksaw Butch Reed escapes to a sanctuary. And as the Hacksaw maneuvers outside the ring, reminds you that our main event is a great tag team, a mixed tag team, Mike Boderick and Stella Mae French against Gino Hernandez and his lady bodyguard, Andrea the Lady Giant Nicola. Hacksaw misses again, but Iceman King Parsons has not missed a beat in this bout. He is moving to certainly the beat of the right drummer here against Hacksaw, who started out with a lot of mouth, now seems to be quieted a bit. Rocco Lovich, the referee. Oh, Iceman Butch Reed, maneuvering position here. Have not had a report from the hospital on the condition of Kevin Von Erich as yet. Kevin taken to the emergency ward of Baylor Hospital for examination following the attack by Chris Adams, hitting him in the back of the head with a chair after Kevin had beaten Chris in the captain's match. We'll let you know as soon as we hear something. Boy, Iceman King Parsons is on target. He has given Butch Reed a what for in the early moments of this bout. The big man from Atlanta is groggy, staggering, and hanging on. Great crowd on hand for Wrestling Star Wars at the Cotton Bowl. Iceman hammering away, tattooing the Hacksaw Man. Well, it's been an Iceman show all the way. Hacksaw welcoming with a lot of threats, a lot of challenges, and all Iceman has done is accept all of them and return them in kind. Iceman King Parsons going for the victory right here, but not quite enough. Hacksaw trying to shake it off, but he's not having much success. Iceman keeps hammering home. Hacksaw has not done anything as yet. Oh, there he did it. Got that knee up just in time and put Iceman on the mat. Now let's see if Hacksaw can follow through with something. Well, the crowd picks up the beat. So finally the tide turns for Hacksaw Butch Reed. Just a couple of shots, now comes back and gives a regain some confidence. And that'll slow down Iceman King Parsons. 5 minutes gone in this bout. Mr. Pulley just told us. Butch Reed trying to recover some of his lost ego in the early part of the bout. Hey, there goes the Iceman with a sojourn on the floor. Hacksaw keeping Iceman off balance and outside the ring. We've just mentioned, of course, our main event is a mixed tag team. And coming up next week, the great tag team event, Kerry and Mike Von Erich against Killer Khan and the Missing Link. Here are a couple of beauties from Devastation Incorporated. Marco Levy putting the count on Iceman Keen Parsons. Butch Reed welcomes him back. So this bout has gone one way or the other. All Iceman, now it's all Butch Reed. Clearly a man who is physically well built. This Butch Reed, an Iceman, catches him a little nonchalant. This might do it. If he can roll him up. Got him going and down and one. Oop, but a hammer on the head. Butch Reed's back in action. Well, Iceman Keith Parson looked like he had this one all sewed up. And right now he is the one being sewn. Now Butch Reed with a chance to win it, but Iceman fighting out of there. They get a double on the chin lock. Iceman and Butch Reed wrapped up in a tough battle on Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars at the eminently popular and successful State Fair of Texas. Internationally known for its magnificence. And a crowd trying to come up now to give Iceman a little bit of their support. As right here on the grounds of the internationally famous, one of the greatest, largest state fairs in all the world. And a Cotton Bowl that rings with history, collegiate and professional sports. And Iceman's ringing a bell on Butch Reed right now. Whack! Really good shots right through him. Iceman picking up the tempo. Look out. Butch Reed whacked back. Got him again. Body slam. This might do it. One, two, not enough. What a seesaw contest this has been. And a clothesline by the finish Hacksaw. Not quite, he's not hung out to dry yet. But there's the bell, and it's all over. And Iceman might have won it had he had just about five more seconds. But the bell ends this dramatic event of the Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars. Let's see if Iceman and Butch Reed got to get after it a little bit more.
Bronco Lubitsch calls it a time limit draw.
But they're still going to have a few more shots. Butch Reed now decides that's enough. And he pulls out. So the Iceman is king of the hill. But this is a time limit draw. No winner.
This event, one fall, 15-minute time limit. First of all, on my right, from lands unknown, represented by General Akbar and Devastation Incorporated, weighing 245 pounds, the Missing Link. And his challenger, on my left in the red coat, from Nashville, Tennessee, also weighing 240 pounds, Mr. George Weingraw. Your referee is Rick Hazard.
And this is world-class championship wrestling from the Cotton Bowl, the famed football stadium where so many great famous events have occurred in college football and the Dallas Cowboys. And right above us is Skander Akbar. Well, the Missing Link, there he is, from parts unknown and certainly strange apparition. as he wanders about the ring now against George Weingroff, the missing link. Great crowd on hand. Beautiful skies overhead, these Texas skies over the Cotton Bowl. As we're ready to go with our first bout, Weingroff and the missing link. Rick Hazard, the referee. You notice a strange offensive maneuver that the missing link always makes, grabbing that hunk of hair and aiming himself. Weingroff with a nice flying drop kick. Weingroff set up to do it again, and the link comes in battering with that head of his, which must be the hardest head in humanity, if that fits, the word humanity fits the link. Here comes the link again, driving the head into the ribs and kidneys of George Weingroff. Physically impaired because he is noticed legally blind, but certainly does not hamper his great ability in the wrestling ring. Right now, though, he is hampered by something that you really don't know how to attack. The link, who used his head as though it were the point of a spear or a battering ram from the days of the Roman conquerors, who crashed into various castles and redoubts around the world. And that's what the link, aiming, crashing across the chest and jaw of George Weingroff. World-class championship wrestling will be in San Antonio tomorrow. San Antonio, the great city in the south of Texas. And Weingroff comes roaring off the ropes and hammers the missing link. Dropping in is the missing link on George Weingroff. The link now has Weingroff in trouble. Well, Skander Akbar, probably because he was raving as the match got underway, is concerned about the fact that his two American tag team champions, the Irwins, Bill and Hogg, lost their championship to the Fantastics. So he is really disturbed. Here comes the link. High on the top rope. Battering ram on the back of the head. Weingroff is down. One, two, three, and he is out. So the missing link has struck again. And Skander Akbar may be a bit more generous now as his man defeated George Weingroff. And here's Ralph Pulley with the time.
The winner in 4 minutes and 25 seconds, the missing link.
The blue skies of Texas, the Cotton Bowl, the missing link, and world-class championship wrestling. And we'll be back with the Fantastics and more on world-class championship wrestling. Well, Butch Reed is not exactly your cordial, considerate type individual, is he? And of course, a lot of this is mental. You got to believe. You've got to believe. Arm wrestling championships are really something now. I've seen them on television. Well, here is an arm wrestling championship.
Hey, you know what you're doing? You know what you're doing? Oh, damn it, you get it lined up right, all right?
And Rick Hazard setting it up now.
Hey! You tell us something. I'm back up on the damn table a little bit. You understand?
And again, still psyching, still working. Hazard.
Shut up!
Now moving around. All right. Butch Reed may be ready. And all you have to do here is just watch. Watch very carefully. The picture tells the story.
Hey, sucker!
A little dispute there over whether it was ready or not.
You keep your hands yourself, Tump, or you wind up like Kevin did. Kevin, his hand laid all wide open. Sit down, boy. Shut up, boy!
You can certainly see why Hacksaw has the nickname Hacksaw. He is not exactly a quiet, not assertive person.
Get his arm off there where mine is!
That is, of course, to get the same leverage. I want to give any. Very carefully controlled. Goal, that's the term, goal. Hacksaw with a very distinct early advantage. Carey coming back. Carey coming back. They're up even again. Carey's taking it away from him right now. Carey's moving over the other side. Boy, this one could go for a long time, although Carey seems to be taking it to him. A little extra effort in there by Hacksaw. Tremendous, tremendous exertion. Not quite, not quite. Carey just above the table. Now it's back again. Now White. Blood rushing out of pressure in Carey's hand. Extreme, extreme effort. Carey Von Erich and Hacksaw Butch Reed. They really work it back and forth, back and forth. Tremendous muscular agility of both of these men. Cannot lift the elbow off the table. With the referee watching very carefully. But they can use that other arm as a lever on the other side. It's washed back and forth, back and forth. $5,000 arm wrestling championship. Carey close. Carey very close. He wins it. Carey Von Erich has defeated Hacksaw Butch Reed. If it's going to be one out of three, or are they going to? Is that it? Well, maybe the table collapsed. I'm not sure. They're still discussing it. And Butch Reed doesn't like the table. Carey Von Erich took Butch Reed down, that's for sure. Ah, Butch Reed kicked the table out. They had that tight shot on the arms, and it was not a victory. He knocked the table out. So the referee is apparently on top of it and says it is no contest at this moment because Reed kicked the table leg out. Did not see that part of it. We saw the arm go down, but didn't see Reed kick the table. So they go back to continue. And we watch carefully again now as they start. Same spot, hand of the referee in. Go, and they're off again. And Reed taking the advantage early as he did when this bout first opened. Is a tremendous amount of exertion. The crowd chanting. Very close. And down again goes the table. And Reed once again goes up.
The table went down. I'm not see if this is going to be the final decision or not. And the winner, Kerry Von Erich. So with the pressure of Kerry Von Erich's arm. I think he again kicked the table. And it appeared, though, that Kerry Von Erich's arm had taken Reed down. And Reed evidently kicked the table again and was disqualified by the referee. And Reed is a very, very upset young man, and not only losing $5,000, but losing physical superiority face. Oh, Hacksaw Butch Reed. And Reed comes back in now.
Table right there.
And we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment.
This event, one fall, 20-minute time limit. This is a tag team match. First of all, in front of me, from Canada, weighing 260 pounds, Mr. Kelly Kaniski. And his partner, from Mexico, weighing 240 pounds, El Diablo. And their opponents, right behind me here. From the City of Angels, first of all, weighing 235 pounds, Mr. Tommy Rogers. And his partner, also weighing 235 pounds, Mr. Bobby Fulton. Your referee is Rick Hazard.
The Fantastics. The Fantastics, I guess, Kelly Kaniski and El Diablo. And he may get started here a little early as the Fantastics from Los Angeles, California. Tremendously popular, coming up with the Texas flag and the American Tag Team Championship, which they won just recently over Wild Bill Irwin. Wild Bill Irwin and his brother Hog Irwin. So they have entered the World Class Championship arena in this area with great credentials. And they're ready to go against these two. Should be a wild, exciting match. Speaking of tag team events, I understand that the rumors are flying that Sunshine, the famed, the one and only Sunshine, the beauteous blonde, is going to be reappearing in that mixed tag match, which features Stella May and Nikla, or Andrea, the Lady Giant, whichever way you want to call her. So we're looking forward with excitement and relish to see Sunshine again. And now we look to excitement here as the Fantastics. We're the first one out, Bobby Fulton, taking on El Diablo, the Scourge of Mexico. In the corners, Kaniski and Tommy Rogers. The Fantastics, colorful, exciting, real outstanding young men. And they have outstanding records and reputations internationally. Ah, shot to the midsection. And El Diablo crashes early, and here comes Tommy Rogers with a young man from Los Angeles with a great move. They certainly represent the excitement and intense interest and youth of today. Nice fireman's move by Tommy Rogers coming up underneath the lift. Take Diablo's got an extended arm right away. Rogers and Fulton go after it. And of course, when you speak of Stella May and Nikla Roberts, you're speaking too of a great bout coming up between those two. Facing off, girl to girl. We look forward to that one. Now here's Kelly Kaniski. He too is in blue trunks, but I haven't seen him make quite the moves that the Fantastics have made. Look out, Kaniski made a move, and look at that arm drag by Bobby Fulton. Tommy Rogers coming right back. This is one thing this team, leapfrog in. Kaniski catches it on the shoulder. That's an arm again. And Tommy Rogers continues to explode all over his adversary. Arm drag. And look who's on top, Tommy Rogers. As we look forward to exciting events for the rest of this year, let's don't forget Thanksgiving's Holiday Spectacular. And is it a spectacular? You'll be hearing more about that as we move through this fabulous month of the fall. The Thanksgiving Holiday Spectacular with a tremendous array of stars. Coming right back in is Tommy Rogers. He's the official one. Now they say no tag. Bobby Fulton getting the support. The referee lost contact with which one was in. And he's questioning it, but they pulled it off very neatly. There goes Tommy. Run through Kaniski. Up and under Kaniski. Great drop kick. Kaniski almost upended. Again, and Kaniski down hard. Cotton Bowl, Wrestling Star Wars. There it is, part of that famed Cotton Bowl that the Dallas Cowboys started. But now the Kansas City Chiefs started as the old Dallas Texans. And of course, it goes on back to the great periods of yesteryear in the 450s when, and on back in college football. But right now, becomes a historic moment with world-class championship wrestling here. And Kaniski is taking the measure right now of Bobby Fulton. Gets some help from El Diablo, who comes in. They're holding him up. Diablo gets an assist from Kaniski and wears away on Fulton. Nice move, Diablo struggling into the corner. Fulton hooks it. Fulton drags him back and gets some help from buddy Tommy Rogers. Oh, these two young men are quick. That looked like a little hair pull in there, but Diablo's moving so rapidly, I don't think it's, into the knee of Kaniski. They're gonna make a lot of moves here, and they're gonna be fast moves. Kaniski's the official one now with Tommy Rogers. Kaniski with a, waiting for it. Body slam. A big Kaniski, 240-pound, hammers into the neck of Tommy Rogers. Rogers in trouble. Handsome young man from California. Clothesline by Kaniski. Oh, that was close. Just got to two, not quite three. And Tommy Rogers up again. Here comes Diablo as Kaniski and Diablo have it going now on Rogers. Bobby Fulton encouraging his partner, but he hasn't been able to get in. Totally out of the area. El Diablo. Bulldogging down on Tommy Rogers. Two and not quite three. Rogers firing out for some reason. Got out of there, a little extra adrenaline to get up.
5 minutes.
5 minutes gone in this box. Gorgeous Texas skies overhead is Wrestling Star Wars. Watches a fantastic hammer in with Kaniski. And Kaniski and company right now with a backbreaker. Here comes El Diablo back. Well, the count goes on Kaniski. And Bobby Fulton trying to help his partner. Meanwhile, Diablo has reverse chinlock. Diablo is in with Tommy Rogers. Tommy Rogers been taking the brunt of the attack from Kaniski and Diablo here. And Rogers would like a moment of rest, a chance to get over and tag his partner, Bobby Fulton. The Fantastics, the American Tag Team Champion. They wrested that championship away from Wild Bill Irwin and Scott Hogg Irwin. Diablo changes with Kaniski. But Tommy still doesn't have a chance to move in. to tag his partner, Bobby. Kaniski. Hanging him up to dry. Kaniski now hanging him out on the mat of world-class championship wrestling. Hammered away. Rogers taking a lot of punishment. Two well-conditioned men, these young fantastics, but also equally conditioned as Kaniski. Well, the fans show their allegiance. Tommy Rogers in trouble here in this battle of World Class Championship Wrestling. Our main event is a six-man world title match. Diablo changing with Kaniski. Now the referee has to see that, but he did not. Now Hazard is trying to recall which one was in. Well, Kaniski stays in the corner. King's X. Kaniski comes right back in again and takes over against Tommy Rogers. Kaniski, Rogers up. This is on the flying drop kick. Rogers trying to get one shot in and move over to his partner, Bobby Fulton, but he didn't make it. Steps into a kick from Kaniski. To remind you of the great places.
Come on, Tom.
The great places to see World Class Championship Wrestling. Don't forget.
Come on, Tommy.
The matches will be coming soon to Corpus Christi, Texas.
Come on, Tommy.
And Rogers getting a kick to the midsection from Diablo. Well, Diablo on top trying to get the pin. One, two, but not quite enough. And in the midsection of Tommy Rogers. And Rogers has been out there a long time. Fulton wants to get into the act. And they're meanwhile, they're choking Tommy Rogers to oblivion over there. Tommy Rogers caught up in the hard-nosed attacks of Diablo and Kaniski, but he escapes and here comes Fulton. Fulton, who wants a little bit of everybody. Fulton. Let's Kaniski take the shot. Fulton by himself. Hanging out. There Kaniski goes to the mat. Diablo goes down. Rogers flies into the air up top. One, two, three. And the winner is on the fantastic. Rogers and Fulton exchange in the corner as he held Diablo. And then Rogers did that fantastic flying body slam pin on Diablo. And here's Ralph Pulley.
The winners in 9 minutes and 22 seconds, the Fantastics.
And we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling excitement in just a moment. It's the main event. Wrestling Star Wars at the Cotton Bowl in Dallas, Texas. And here's Stella Bay, Mike Von Erich, one half of this mixed tag team, Stella Bay French, the nemesis of Gino Hernandez, who is wrapping himself in all those championship belts, and his lady bodyguard, Nicola Roberts, better known as Andrea, the Lady Giant. And this should be a most interesting bout, as Ralph Pulley will...
This is a special challengers match. One fall, 45 minute time limit. First of all, over here on my right, the American heavyweight champion and the Texas heavyweight champion from Highland Park, Gino Hernandez.
I am your champion.
And his partner, Nicola Roberts, better known as Andrea, the Lady Giant. And their challengers, first of all, from Denton County, weighing 225 pounds, Mike Von Erich. And his partner, Stella Mae French. Your referee is David Manning.
Vegeta Hernandez covered up for the American and Texas heavyweight titles and the sixth man. And Chris Adams, he and Jake the Snake Roberts took for the Von Erichs. This is an outdoor match, and the fans are not talking about the natural sunshine. They're talking about the young lady known as Sunshine, Stella Bay's niece. And that's really kind of how Stella Bay got into all of this wrestling war, by coming to the aid and defense in the honor of Sunshine. But now here she is, matched up with Mike Von Erich against Gina Hernandez and Nicola Roberts. Oh, Nicola's going to take off all the leathers as Gino postulates about all the problems.
Let's go, Joe.
David Manning explaining the rules and regulations as Nicola Roberts ready to go now with Gino Hernandez against Mike Von Erich and Stella Bay French. And suddenly, lo and behold, here comes a helicopter into the Cotton Bowl, and the crowd sensing some excitement and some drama. And with our long lens camera, you can tell who that is right away. The exotic, the exciting, the girl with the face of a thousand expressions. There she is, she's back, Sunshine. Sunshine's back. Well, for a long time, Stella Bay French was searching for her. And now that Stella Bay has joined in the ranks of world-class championship wrestling, here is Sunshine back, and this should be a very dramatic, emotional experience, and it is. A great celebration. Even Mike Von Erich getting a kiss from Sunshine. She's back right at the appropriate time here for this match. And Sunshine, Stella Mae French, Gino Hernandez now talking about it as the bout is just about ready to go. And see what Sunshine's area of interest is going to be. Probably stay by the ring. This young lady with a great face. Emotionally, if you take a look at her, you know exactly what's going on inside her mind. You can just read that involvement. Stella Bay will start it out against Nicola Roberts. And Stella Bay, the lady who handles those 18-wheelers, goes right to work on Nicola Roberts. No question about this one. She is a tough lady, and Gino Hernandez trying to save his lady as he leaps in and pulls her out of the ring. Well, that wasn't a very auspicious start for Andrea, the Lady Giant, but Stella Bay French just creamed her right in the ring. So Stella Bay right back. Nicola Roberts got to come back in. Let's see. Nope, it's got to be Gino. Gino Hernandez, formerly of Houston, now of Highland Park, a 24-carat suburb of Dallas. Mike Von Erich going against Gino Hernandez. Stella Bay and Sunshine reunited right here at the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. Good work by Mike Von Erich. Oh, the young Mike Von Erich, the youngest of the Von Erich clan, working on Gino Hernandez. Gino comes right back with the head scissors. Well, the word we've just been handed a note, there has been a diagnosis of Kevin Von Erich, a severe laceration in the back of the head. and it will require a number of stitches. First figure we heard somewhere around 10, 15, maybe a few more. That's a goodly number. And Kevin's also, let's see, a severe concussion. Those are certainly understandable, but not life-threatening as it first appeared when Chris Adams banged Kevin Von Erich on the back of the head with a wooden chair. Gino in trouble. But now right in the ring, Nicola, and here is Fu. A shot to Stella Mae French. A little taunting of sunshine as those two ladies point the finger of despair at each other. Well, look at Nicola. She is going hard against Stella Mae French now. Stella Mae obviously in a great deal of pain. And Gino seems to be enjoying every second of it. Listen to the crowd. Stella's having enough trouble just trying to gather breath right at the moment to get up and beat Nicola. And a choke. David Von Erich, or David Manning, rather. Now a Sunshine with a slap on Nicola Roberts. Sunshine working on a chair. Watch this. Wham on Nicola Roberts' head. And it looked like the rope caught some of that, absorbed some of the shock as Nicola went down. But there is Stella Mae putting the count on Nicola. I guess David Manning did not see Sunshine wrap the chair across Nicola Roberts' head, and Gino is furious. Sunshine comforting her aunt. Nicola trying to comfort her head. And Gino has nobody to comfort him. He is furious. He is out of his mind with anger and frustration. Sunshine belting Nicola Roberts on the head with a plastic chair. Fortunately for Nicola, the chair caught the rope and that absorbed some of the shock. Or we might have had to send for an ambulance for Nicola. Well, there's a happy threesome. Stella Mae French.
In 5 minutes and 19 seconds, Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French.
Yes, Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French, the winners. The dramatic, emotional return of Sunshine to this event. And Sunshine has certainly participated rather dominantly in this match. And before we, before she leaves, let's see if we can't get her up here. We'll try to grab her and bring her back just before she gets out of the area.
Don't forget Molly, I'm on sale outside the main entrance.
Again. Everybody's hey,
you got into the bout, didn't you?
Well, no. Don't mess with my Aunt Stella.
Hey, it's good to see you again. We want to see more of you.
I don't know what my plans are, but I sure am glad to be back.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Sunshine. You made a nice entrance.
There she is, Sunshine. Her plans, well, as yet unknown. But I'm sure that if you ask Stella Mae French and Mike Von Erich, they'll say, let's keep that gal around for quite a while. Well, a tremendous event. The mixed tag team, the winners, Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French. And we'll have more on World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment. And a fantastic bout. Fans all over the world were invited to mail in their preference for this captain's match. These two men were overwhelmingly chosen as the ones the fans wanted to see in the ring to settle this great feud between them. Now, will this match? There's Gary Hart, the advisor and manager of Chris Adams, who says he hasn't changed and all the other folks have changed that we have. And here comes from Denton County, America's hero, Kevin Von Erichsen. A victory in this match in the World Tag Team Championship match will certainly give Kevin a great emotional advantage. Kevin Von Erichsen was wrestling with, you may recall, was wrestling with Chris Adams, I guess Gino Hernandez and Jake the Snake Roberts, when the blow-up occurred. Chris Adams and Gary Hart attacking Stella Mae French. And then Chris super-kicking Kevin. And thus the friendship ended. And thus a new alliance. Chris Adams, Gino Hernandez, and Jake Roberts. And now let's go to Ralph Pulley in the ring.
This event, one fall, 30-minute time limit. This match features the captains for the World Six-Man Tag Team title, chosen by you, the fans, in the largest write-in campaign vote in the history of professional wrestling. First of all, on my left, from England, weighing 235 pounds, gentleman Chris Adams. He is assisted by his advisor, Gary Hart. And his challenger in front of me here in the yellow trunks from Denton County, weighing 240 pounds, Kevin Von Erich. The referee is David Manning.
Kevin Von Erich is seeking the American Heavyweight Championship. Chris Adams is looking for the World Heavyweight Championship. And Chris Adams wants to talk. You notice he got a
Kevin
lot of
Von Erich.
Negatives, here's Chris.
Keep your kicking and your punching to yourself, because what I'm going to do is challenge you to a wrestling match, Von Erich, something that you're not very used to, and I'm going to embarrass you in front of your brothers, in front of your father, and in front of everybody here.
Well, Chris Adams hurling another challenge at Kevin Von Erich. And now Kevin wants the microphone. Well, Kevin does have a reply.
Adams, you want to humiliate me? You want a straight, clean wrestling match? Okay, man, you got it.
Well, we'll see which one follows through on this particular challenge. Gary Hart leaving the ring. Now, Chris Von Erich has said that if Gary Hart interferes in any way, Fritz will be there like a postage stamp on an envelope all over. A little byplay there as David Manning introduces the wrestlers to each other. They well know each other. So Gary Hart must be careful, because somewhere in this giant cotton bowl, somewhere lurking, ready to spring out, is probably Fritz Von Erich. I have not seen him. I just know that he warned Gary Hart forcefully that if Gary interfered in any way, he was going to be there. Look at Chris do his gymnastics. Well, Chris Adams didn't like that little light slap on the face. Well, Chris, what is he? He says now wants to keep it clean. Do they really, will they? Will they just do a straight wrestling match? It'll be very difficult after what has happened between them. This may be the first indication. Ah, they broke cleanly. Chris came off nicely. I wonder also if this might just be a ploy set up by Gary Hart to lure Kevin a bit into an area that he would be less cautious. And then all at once, Chris might explode on him. I don't know. I would hate to think Chris would be that way. Here's an arm-barred hammerlock. Chris Adams jousting with Kevin. And when you talk about the ability to maneuver in gymnastics and roll and leap and head about the ring, Kevin Von Erich is second to none. Kevin Von Erich, second to none. Kevin Von Erich, Chris Adams. This is about everybody's been waiting for since they parted company. Good hammerlock in by Adams. Rolling McChriston staying with him. Rolling Kevin, Chris stayed with him. I remember when Chris Adams came to this part of the country from England, and he immediately became very close friends with the Von Erichs. At that hammerlock, Chris maintains it. Kevin tried to pick up some steam and come out of it. Chris rolls off. Kevin turned back inside. Nice move. Gives 1 point to Kevin Von Erich. Chris a little upset. More with himself, I think, than with Kevin, because Kevin fooled him. Nice sidemare move by Chris Adams. Stratford on Avon, England. The Bard lived there. Shakespeare. Chris Adams lives there when he's there. Of course, traveling about the world as he does the world-class championship wrestling. He's not in England very much. A super heavy, hard headlock put on Kevin Von Erich by Chris Adams. Gary Hart has not moved, but he has looked. Kind of glanced around the arena. Nice leg takedown by Kevin Von Erich.
Oh, come on.
There's another point for Chris. For Kevin on Chris. Barring those legs. Those legs. I've watched Gary Hart. Caught him out of the corner of my eye over there in the corner. And he looks around. Kind of furtively looks one way and then the other. As though he might be looking to see a large, strong adversary that he's known in the past, Fritz Von Erich. Right now, Kevin Von Erich in control of Chris Adams. As that leg barred, Chris makes it to the ropes, breaks, and Kevin breaks. No extraneous, no extracurricular activity. They have both played it fairly. And even though Chris is parted company with the Von Erichs, there's a British Union Jack flying in the hands of a young lady over. One young lady had "I love Chris Adams, I love Kevin Von Erich" on her shirt. Crowd looking back, and so is Gary as the fans are standing. Maybe they spotted Fritz Von Erich. Chris Adams moving in. Fakes the toe hold, goes into the headlock, the chin lock. Crowd standing up, looking back behind us. Everybody expects Fritz Von Erich to be here, to be around, and I'm sure he is. Union Jack flies again over there. As Chris Adams has Kevin Von Erich in that chin lock now. Kevin breaks it. They were on the ropes. It may well be that Chris can maintain his normally gentleman attributes, even associated with Gino Hernandez and Jake the Snake Roberts and Gary Hart. I would find that very difficult to consider that he could do that for a long time, but, oh, nice move by Kevin. Up and a body slam by Kevin Von Erich. Couple of slaps, nice slap. Whoa, get down, wound up. Little redness, little temper. Gary Hart making a signal as though to kind of cool it. Now Gary Hart putting his hand up and saying, cool it, there he is. Even in a regulated bout between two good friends, it would be difficult to maintain that quiet aplomb that professionals have to do when they're working under the rules. Chris coming in after that nice move against the quarter buckle. Chris Adams on Kevin Von Erich. Cotton, there's Gary Hart looking very carefully in. Not the hand across the face, but not in the eyes as Kevin Von Erich tries to use his great strength and agility to move out of this chin lock. Crowd into this one. Chris Adams and Kevin Von Erich working. A good, great crowd on hand in the Cotton Bowl. It holds 65,000 to 70,000, so. And here is a shoulder stand, but Chris Adams rolls out, and Gary Hart, for the first time, came out of his chair, and he looks around. And we see no Fritz von Erich. Now they're all tangled up in that corner, and David Manning trying to untangle them. There's a couple of balls to the midsection. Those are legal. A clothesline. Chris Adams getting a little advantage now on Kevin von Erich with that clothesline. But Kevin driving his shoulder, coming off the blocks like a football lineman. Good move by Kevin. Chris Adams double kicked out of there. Kevin resting, getting a chance to recuperate. Harry Hart says, cool it again, using both hands to say, lay down easy. Don't get carried away. Control yourself. There he is. See that motion? Ah, yes, the famed Cotton Bowl. Speaking of people controlling themselves in great adversity. Oh, good wrist lock moving in. Adams on a twist. Kevin holds it on, got the arm, drags it, and maintains it. And speaking of men working under great adversity, one of the great quarterbacks of all time in the NFL, Don Meredith, played right here on this Cotton Bowl turf in those great formative years of the Dallas Cowboys. Kevin, oh, Chris, with a hit on the break. Well, that's the first real impolite fraction of the rules that we've seen. Chris taking advantage of it. Kevin coming off, driving up is Chris Adams. A few of the fans for Chris as Chris jams in on Kevin, and maybe now it's open up. Nice side, high side mare move by Chris Adams, who now seems to think he's in control. A super kick, and Kevin von Erich is out on the floor. A super kick, and Kevin von Erich is out on the deck of the Cotton Bowl here at the State Fair of Texas. Fan over there with a sign, hand-painted sign. Chris is still number one. Kevin back in. Here comes Kevin. Nice move by Adams. Watch here. Whoa! Kevin almost in our lap as he flies over Chris Adams, who is running. Another. It's a flying drop kick, not a super kick. But Kevin stumbling out of the ring with a chance to rest. A chance to get a little bit. There's Kay! Adams flying out between the ropes on top of Kevin von Erich. And Chris Adams back in. Chris demonstrating all sorts of maniacal moves here as he grabs Kevin and brings him back in. Coming up with a suplex, but Kevin turns it around. Now it's up and over. A shoulder stand. One, two, three, and Kevin von Erich beats Chris Adams. Kevin von Erich defeats Chris Adams. Gary Hart is explaining it. Adams had his shoulder was off the mat. Well, Chris is a little upset, and you can certainly understand why he picked up the bell here. Kevin von Erich, the winner, but Chris Adams feels he was robbed. I was looking for Gary Hart, he's right to my right here. And here's Kevin. I'll see if I can get
him. Hey, man. What are you acting that way for? That was a clean match, and I won it fair and square.
Gary Hart right down to my left.
Now, Chris, I'm going to make you a deal. I can't believe myself right now I'm making, but I'll tell you what. You fire Gary Hart. Get rid of him, and I'll try to bury the hatchet and forget it ever happened. Be water under the bridge.
Well, that's an interesting challenge. And Gary Hart is right here to my left.
Chris, here's a microphone. I'm leaving it up to you. Make your own decision.
And Chris is certainly thinking it over. Gary Hart up on the apron of the ring. And Kevin Von Erich hit from behind by Chris Adams. And having the chair in on Kevin Von Erich has gone absolutely crazy here. And Gary Hart now looking around, and he wants to get out of here. Kevin Von Erich smashed on the back of the head. Blood running down from the back of his head. He has been terribly hit from behind by Chris Adams. Gary Von Erich in the ring, David Manning in the ring. And Kevin lying on the mat here in front of us as Gary Hart seeks to escape. And escape is a true word because the fans are infuriated. And undoubtedly, Fritz Von Erich is somewhere about wishing to get Gary Hart's scalp.
Ted, give him anybody. We're going to need an ambulance. Anybody, we're going to need an ambulance now.
I am sorry to say that from my point of view here, it would appear that Kevin Von Erich has received a very severe blow to the head. You see the fans, Gary Von Erich's around, some of the fans trying to get up to help, but David Manning is there. Kevin is conscious. His feet are moving. Listen, you can hear some of the discussion there. Kevin saying his feet and hands are burning. Now the Von Erich, bodyguards are here. The police are up here. And I think they have sent for an ambulance.
Hey, is that doctor in the dressing room coming? He said he's got no feeling, man. He said his hands, he can't do nothing.
And listen, David Manning, that there is no feeling in his hands. But undoubtedly, a concussion would cause that sort of reaction. So I don't want to bring you to a point of the worst that we could possibly think. At this moment, he is injured. I've called an ambulance. There is an ambulance on hand all the time, of course, for first aid and Cotton Bowl and other major stadia. And that's fortunate because right now, as Chris Adams came across the ring with that wooden chair, which is lying in the ring right there.
As the ambulance drives onto the floor of the Cotton Bowl near the State Fair of Texas, we'll take a break and return to this incident of Chris Adams and Kevin Von Erich on World Class Championship Wrestling. Paramedics have arrived, are now administering first aid to the stricken Kevin Von Erich, struck in the back of the head by Chris Adams in the match after Kevin had won it.
Kev, you need to try to stay still, man, okay?
Paramedics.
Just try to stay still.
Specially trained for this type of first aid.
Lonnie, they're going to go to Baylor Hospital. Okay?
Preparing Kevin to take him to Baylor Hospital in Dallas. And of course, his injuries will be diagnosed there. Huge crowd stunned by the severity of the attack of Chris Adams on Kevin Von Erich. Now Kevin Von Erich wheeled to the emergency ambulance, getting the best of first aid from these paramedics located at the State Fair of Texas. So here's the result of that dastardly behind-the-back attack of Chris Adams, a former friend of Kevin Von Erich, striking Kevin from behind with a wooden chair. And now the paramedics moving Kevin into the ambulance and onto the hospital, where his injuries will be diagnosed and he'll receive the aid that's necessary to put him back in shape to get back in that ring and wrestle some more. Stunned fans watching their hero from Denton County, Texas, Kevin Von Erich, being taken to the hospital. We'll be back with more. Championship Wrestling. In the ring right now, Jake the Snake Roberts, Gino Hernandez, and Chris Adams. And here come the Von Erichs, at least two of them. Kevin Von Erich was hurt earlier in a match today with Chris Adams. He's been taken to the hospital. And so with this six-man tag team continuing, there will have to be a substitute for Kevin Von Erich. We'll bring you an update and highlights in our next program on the attack on Kevin Von Erich. There's Mike Von Erich, Terry behind him. I have not yet been notified as to the replacement. See who is going to replace Kevin Von Erich. Right now it's Mike and Kerry in the ring. Gino Hernandez, there's Mike. And let's go now to Ralph Pulley.
To introduce our main event for the afternoon, it's one of the DJs from Eagle 97. From what I hear, one of the greatest DJs in America today, Rich Bryant.
All right, Jack, thank you very much. I'd like to introduce the challengers first. In this corner, weighing in at 240 pounds from Highland Park, Gino Hernandez. One of his partners, weighing in at 235 pounds from Louisiana, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Come on.
Last, I'd like to introduce from England, at 235 pounds, gentleman Chris Adams.
And I
also
know
in their corner,
the
Andrea, the lady giant. And Chris's manager, Gary Hart. Now I'd like to introduce the champions for the World 16 six-man tag team championship. Substituting at the request of the Von Erich family for Kevin Von Erich, one of the Fantastics from the City of Angels at 230 pounds, Bobby Fulton. Next, at 260 pounds, from Denton County, Kerry Von Erich. And at 222 pounds, also from Denton County, Mike Von Erich. Your referee, David Manning.
For that gold medal that Ric Flair has around his waist.
And
this
so,
is just the beginning.
We see that Bobby Fulton has replaced Kevin Von Erich. Bobby Fulton, who has replaced Kevin Von Erich, injured in an earlier bout with Chris Adams, has been taken to hospital for observation and for prognosis of his injury.
All right, you gotta see the belt.
So Bobby Fulton, Mike Von Erich, and Kerry Von Erich will defend the six-man World Tag Team Championship against Roberts, Hernandez, and Adams. I was looking for Stella May. Whoa, it's already started as Chris Adams and Kerry Von Erich and Mike all got into it. Now it is Mike and Jake the Snake, and Fulton gives Snake a hammer, and everybody's out of the ring except the Von Erich side. You remember it was the Von Erich a couple of years ago who helped win that six-man in a display of comradeship and devotion. Now it is Kerry Von Erich and Mike Von Erich and Bobby Fulton. And Gino is going to be the first one in. We'll see who is going to be. Well, Kerry wants the microphone.
Adams, you're any kind of man. You start right now.
Chris is saying he wants to start, but Gary Hart
is having Gino start. Gino really is the captain, I guess you would say, of this crew. And Chris Adams up on the ring, and he is, here he is, trying to get the fans and everybody to get Chris Adams in first. And Chris said he'd like to start, but Gino, the captain of this crew, the three-man group, is going to start first against Kerry Von Erich, and that certainly Chris will be in the bout. Andrea, the lady giant, standing over to the side. Do not see Stella May around the area. Thought she might be near the ringside, but if she did come up, there'd probably be a battle with Andrea. So ready to go now is Kerry Von Erich and Gino Hernandez, the American heavyweight champion and the Texas champion, got it going on this championship bout. Kerry Von Erich and Gino breaking cleanly. I guess that shout is Chris is a traitor. Traitor to Von Erichs is the term, of course, as he is a traitor. He betrayed, really more than a traitor, betrayed a friendship and an association. Oh, there goes Gino. Wow. Up and over. Look out. Top kick on Gino. Here's Jake the Snake. And the Snake comes sizzling in, hissing. Kind of psyching his man out. Jake, who likes to, there's a lot of body language. And is very, very quick. Tall, angular, but very quick and very devilish. You see right there, short uppercut. Another one. Snake, I noticed too, has a red streak in his hair. There goes the Snake. Look out, right into that body slam. I don't know what the Snake was thinking about. I guess he thought he was home free. All he did was step right back into trouble. And that'll make him shed a little skin as he rubs across the back of that mat in this six-man World Tag Team Championship. There's the famed Cotton Bowl press box. This is Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars. Now hammering in is Mike Von Erich taking Kerry's place, and Mike Von Erich starts to work. Mike Von Erich putting up, trying to get a pin, but not in time. Digna World Class Championship Wrestling. Visiting El Paso, the Western Gateway to Texas tomorrow. El Paso, fantastic city on the border of New Mexico and Mexico. Mike Von Erich hammering the Snake. Here comes Gino, and Gino trying to take advantage, but didn't do very well. Snake couldn't hold Mike Von Erich, and Mike right now has an extended wrist lock on Gino. And Gino now facing Buddy Fulton, Bobby Fulton, one of the fantastic. Bobby Fulton replacing the injured Kevin Von Erich. We'll bring you an update next week in the highlights, next program of what happened to Kevin Von Erich, and then the following week, the bout itself. No information on the extent of the injury to Kevin, but Bobby Fulton replacing Kevin, and here is Chris Adams. And now Kerry Von Erich. Tag, Kerry. There goes Chris out. And Chris says, Gary Hart made me do it. Chris Adams once, at least he is saying, Chris Adams once in that ring. And Gary Hart is saying no.
Opportunity.
You heard that. That was Gary Hart saying the right opportunity. And the right opportunity is not with Kerry Von Erich. Maybe it's with Mike Von Erich, he would assume. Well, the snake is in. And so is Kerry. Kerry! Driving through the quarter buckling, and now it's Adams in, and now with an injured Kerry Von Erich, Chris Adams is in the ring. Clothesline, Kerry down. And Chris Adams going to work on Kerry, stopping his ankle. Chris Adams. Here comes Gino Hernandez in now, and a drop in on the leg and knee of Kerry Von Erich. Making a move now with Snake. Jake the Snake Roberts in. And they're trying to disable the right leg and knee of Kerry Von Erich. Kerry, who threw himself into the corner buckle. Kerry now, who has the attack of Jake the Snake Roberts tearing on his right knee, and the crowd in a frenzy. The six-man world tag team championship is at stake. 5 minutes gone in this bout. And Kerry Von Erich, limping on his right leg, comes up and over, might get a roll up, will it? Chris Adams in, and Chris hammers on the head of Kerry Von Erich. There was a tag as Jake the Snake Roberts went by. That legal tag now as Chris Adams is in, and he kicks the leg out from under Kerry Von Erich. And again, that right leg and knee, and Kerry in tremendous trouble. The choke and the count. As Kerry does something, has a super kick. A super kick. And Kerry Von Erich is down at Chris Adams. Makes a tag with Jake the Snake Roberts. Jake the Snake with his kick. Is he going to give him a DDT? That's his poison hole, his finishing hole. Jake the Snake, double shot to the head. Jake the Snake. Now Gino Hernandez, and they have it going. And they've got Kerry Von Erich going, and Kerry missed. Midsection shot by Gino Hernandez. And Kerry with a drop kick of Gino Hernandez. We'll see if Kerry has enough to get back now, and Gino is shaken. Here comes Chris Adams. A tag, not in time. Chris got in front. Shot to the head, a shot to midsection, another one, and Kerry Von Erich coming back, and Chris Adams in trouble. The ball, a discus punch. Kerry trying to get to the corner. A tag on Mike Von Erich, and Mike is in, and Kerry taking the rest, and Mike is all over Chris Adams. Well, Mike Von Erich is attacking Chris Adams with a fury. Chris now in the middle rope, and Gino kicks him off. But with all this outstanding activity, don't forget, in Dallas, Turkey Day Spectacular at Reno, a reunion arena coming up. And Gino Hernandez, Jake the Snake Roberts, and Chris Adams. They're combining now on Mike Von Erich. Jake the Snake telling Kerry, there he is. Ripping into Mike Von Erich, one. Two, but not enough for three. Jake kicked off by Mike, and again, Mike goes down, grabbing the hair. Here comes Chris Adams back in. Chris driving in on the Von Erichs, and of course, this threesome would like, if they can do it, they would like to be one of the Von Erichs, because Fulton is replacing Kevin, and now it has been an attack on Kerry and Mike. Hard shot to the jaw. Mike kicks back. Mike. And now it's Kerry Von Erich back again. Jake the Snake. One, two, and the count goes on. And Kerry Von Erich back with Jake the Snake Roberts. Kerry with a blow to the head. Here comes the Snake back. He's got a drop. Kerry trying to get back. Here comes Bobby Fulton, the replacement for the injured Kevin Von Erich in an earlier match with Chris Adams. Kevin taken to the hospital with indeterminate injuries. And we have not yet. A suplex by Gino Hernandez. of Bobby Fulton. Right, Tito, he misses. Bobby Fulton has a chance right here. Well, Bobby's trying to get to the corner. He needs a replacement. He makes it with Mike Von Erich. So Bobby Fulton, who replaced Kevin, injured in an earlier bout with Chris Adams. We have not had a report as yet on Kevin's prognosis. A sleep hold by Mike Von Erich. A sleep hold, the tag by Gino and Chris. A hammer on Mike. And we're back to the attack on the Von Erichs. Chris Adams with a body slam. Gary tried to upset Chris Adams from behind, and now it's Mike Von Erich who's in trouble. So, 10 minutes gone in this bout, the World Six-Man Tag Team Championship. It's Gino Hernandez now. Looks like he has a chokehold in there. Now, just Mike Von Erich trying to work his way through Gino. And a change. Bobby Fulton will come in. Mike Von Erich has to get up. Here comes Jake the Snake Roberts in. Let's see what we've got here now with David Manning. Well, David Manning did not allow the Mike Von Erich Fulton interchange. Oh, what a blast there. Al Kerry Von Erich, who eagerly wanted Chris Adams to open the match. Discus punch so that he could gain some revenge for Kevin's injury brought about by Chris Adams. Well, the Von Erich crew is dominating right now. Gary and the Snake having at it. Looks like a suplex right here. A super kick. As super kick as Snake Roberts was in the air. Chris Adams put the super kick on Gary as a two and a three. And Chris Adams, Gino Hernandez, and Jake the Snake Roberts have won the bout, but I don't think the referee saw what occurred there. Here is Ralph Foley.
The winners in 11 minutes and 45 seconds. Gino Hernandez, Jake the Snake Roberts, and Chris Adams. They are the new World Six-Man Tag Team Champions.
The new World Six-Man Tag Team Champion. Chris Adams with a super kick into the midsection and throat of Kerry Von Erich as he had Snake. Jake the Snake Roberts was being held aloft by Kerry for a suplex. And Chris Adams entered the ring illegally and hit Kerry Von Erich with a super kick. So evidently the referee did not see that action. But they're the champions. Ex-champions now. And we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling in a moment. Well, we're in the dressing room of the new six-man World Tag Team Champions. Jake the Snake Roberts and Gary Hart, Chris Adams, and quite an enthusiastic group of
Cotton
Bowl. All right. Let's bring Chris Adams in. I'm not going to try to diminish your victory, but I just want to ask you, were all pleased with two attacks on the Von Erichs?
We got a party to go to.
You were not legal at either event.
What do you mean I wasn't legal? I was legal. Hey, listen. I did what I said I did. I got the gold. This is my first gold.
Really,
my next gold is around Ricky Flair's race right now, but it soon won't be.
And for everyone that thinks that Chris Adams made a mistake and that Chris Adams is a traitor, he ain't no Benedict Arnold. He's the part of the six-man world tag team championship.
You telling me to do all that today?
No suggestions for me. He's so smart, I don't have to tell him.
You're the captain.
We said all along, Jake the Snake right here, Chris Adams and myself would show the Von Erichs that they were nothing. Look at Kevin Von Erich now.
Look at Kevin Von Erich. Look where the world six-man tag team belts are. All the gold. Jake the Snake, they call him crazy. He had nothing but a winner. Chris Adams didn't make no mistake. He's a winner. We're all winners. We are the champions. We are your champions. Whether you like it or not, the Von Erichs can kiss it goodbye. Von Erichs, you are not at the top of the hill no more. You at the bottom of the ladder now. We are the champions. And who? The Von Erichs. Who are the Von Erichs? Kevin who? Gary who? Mike who? They're nothing. They're nothing. We're the champions. They are nothing. Nobody.
We got a party. We got to get out of here. Glad you stopped by.
Let's go to the party.
That's it.
You usually have something.
We got four men and one great lady.
I don't have much to say. Well,
we are your champions.
All right.